Now in lecture 2, we have discussed about the energy of electron, kinetic energy, potential energy, and also its time period, frequency, and also we discussed in the class 2 and derived the equations also. Now let us see the Rydberg, what is the Rydberg constant and what is the wave number and the wavelength. Let us see all these in this lesson 3. Now we have from second postulate we have E2 minus E1 is equals to H nu. We have E2 minus E1 is equals to H nu from the second postulate. Now spectral series or hydrogen spectrum. Let us say if E1 is the energy of the electron in the level N1, in the, let us say, ground level, and E2 is the energy in the higher level. Let us say this is E1, this is E2, this is N1, this is N2. Okay. Now electron may transfer from higher energy level to lower energy level, and E2 minus E1 is equals to H nu. Now we have energy E is equals to, we have derived energy E is equals to minus of m z square e power 4 by 8 epsilon naught square n square h square. We have derived this in class 2. Energy E is equals to minus of m z square e power 4 by 8 epsilon naught square n square h square, that is equals to minus 13.6 z square by n square electron volts. We have derived this in the class 2. Now what is E1 now? If E1 is the energy corresponding principal quantum number N1 or energy level N1, then E1 is equals to minus of m z square e power 4 by 8 epsilon naught square N1 square H square. I am not taking hydrogen. I am considering in general. I discussed this one also. For helium, singly ionized helium, we have to take Z is equals to 2. For doubly ionized lithium, we have to take Z is equals to 3. Therefore, E1 is equals for hydrogen, Z is equals to 1. Therefore, E1 is equals to minus of m Z square e power 4 by 8 epsilon naught square N1 square H square. And E2 is equals to minus of mz square e power 4 by 8 epsilon naught square N2 square H square. Because mass, charge, epsilon naught, permittivity of free space and Planck constant all remains constants. Now, as we know that E2 minus E1 H nu, put this in equation. This, let us see, equation 1, equation 2, equation 3. Now, put 2 and 3 in 1. This implies E2 minus E1 is equals to H nu. This implies E2 is minus of mz square e power 4 by 8 epsilon naught square N2 square H square minus, let us take it as this, minus E1. E1 is equals to minus of minus plus mz square e power 4 by 8 epsilon naught square n2 square h square is equals to h nu. This implies h nu is equals to take common mz square e power 4 by 8 epsilon naught square h square. Then what we have? Minus mz square e power 4 by 8 epsilon square means minus 1 by n2 square plus 1 by, so this is 1 now, this is 1, E2 minus E1 by N1 square. This implies H nu is equals to mz square e power 4 by mz square e power 4 by 8 epsilon naught square H square, epsilon H square into 1 by N1 square minus 1 by N2 square. But we know that, but we have E, nu is equals to c by lambda. Here c is velocity of light. C is velocity of light is equal to 3 into 10 power 8 meter per second. Lambda is the wavelength of emitted spectral line. Lambda is the wavelength of emitted spectral line. This is spectral line is emitted. The wavelength of that emitted spectral line. This implies hc by lambda is equals to h in place of nu put c by lambda. Hc by lambda is equals to mz square e power 4 by 8 epsilon naught square h square into 1 by n1 square minus 1 by n2 square. This implies this implies 1 by lambda is equal to put this hc to denominator here, then m z square e power 4 by 8 epsilon naught square hc, h into h square is h cube, c as it is c h cube into 1 by n1 square minus 1 by n2 square. This implies 1 by, generally we take 1 by lambda is equals to, but we take 1 by lambda is equals to nu bar, the wave number. Nu bar, the wave number, centimeter inverse or meter inverse. Units are centimeter inverse because 1 by wavelength. Wavelength is length unit, centimeter. Reciprocal of that one is centimeter inverse or meter inverse. Therefore, nu bar is equals to 1 by lambda. Nu bar is called as wave number, reciprocal of wavelength. Generally, angular wave number is there. K is equals to 2 pi by lambda. It is called as angular wave number. Angular wave number. We get in the waves. Kx x is equals to a sin omega t minus kx. In that, we get k is equal to 2 pi by lambda is called as angular wave number. So remove this to 2 pi, then angular is removed, then it becomes a wave number only simply. Therefore, nu bar is equals to 1 by lambda, that is equals to m z square e power 4 by 8 epsilon naught square c h cube into 1 by n1 square minus 1 by n2 square. This can be this general expression for wave number nu bar. This further reduces to nu bar is equals to 1 by lambda some r z square into 1 by n1 square minus 1 by n2 square. 1 by n1 square minus 1 by n2 square. Therefore, here r is equals to, what is r here? M e power 4 by 8 epsilon naught square c h cube is called the Rydberg constant. Here put the mass is equals to m is equals to 9.1 into 10 power minus 31 kg. Charge is equals to 1.602 into 10 power minus 19 coulombs. Epsilon naught is equals to 8.854 into 10 power minus 12 farads per meter. C is equals to 3 into 10 power 8 meter per second. H is equals to 6.625 into 10 power minus 34 joule second. If you put all these values here, m is the mass of electron, then we get r is equals to 1.097 into 10 power 7 per meter. 1.097 into 10 power 7 per meter. We get the value of what we call this Rydberg constant. Okay. Now depending on the, now what is the relation between R and energy? We know that energy, this is the expression, this is most important one, very very used in the doing problematic part. R is equals to 1 by lambda is equals to R into Z square into 1 by N1 square minus 1 by N2 square. For hydrogen, what happens? For hydrogen, we get Z is equals to 1. And for singly ionized helium, Z is equals to 2. doubly ionized lithium, Z is equals to 3. If we given like that, then we can use here R. If it is hydrogen, take Z as equals to 1. Take Z as 1. Now let us see the relation between energy and Rydberg constant. Relation between energy and Rydberg constant. That's also a very important one. Energy and Rydberg constant. Now what is R here? R is equals to ME power 4 by R is equals to ME power 4 by 8 epsilon naught square CH cube, and energy E is equals to minus of MZ square E power 4 by 8 epsilon naught square N square H square Now if we put RCH by N square, let us see RCH by N square. Then what will become? RCH means R M E power 4 by 8 epsilon naught square CH cube into CH. Then what happens? CC gets cancelled, H square times. This implies by N square as T. Therefore, RCH is equals to, let us take it as M E power 4 by 8 epsilon naught square CH, M E power over 8 epsilon naught square, N square, H square. If you put minus sign, take minus sign here. Then what it becomes? This becomes the energy for a hydrogen atom. For hydrogen, E H is equals to, Z is equals to 1 for hydrogen. Z is equals to 1 for hydrogen. Therefore, E is equals to, then this becomes 1. Then this becomes energy. This implies by N square, of course. This implies minus of RCH by N square is equals to EN, energy in the nth orbit. Minus of RCH by N square is equals to EN, is energy in the nth orbit. It's a relation between energy and Rydberg constant. Energy and Rydberg constant is also very, very important one. This implies minus of RCH by N square is equals to minus 13.6 by N square electron volts. As we know that EN is equals to minus 13.6 by N square electron volts. Therefore, N gets cancelled. This implies minus of RCH is equals to minus of 13.6 electron volts. Therefore, value of RCH is equals to 13.6 electron volts. That is equals to 13.6 into 1.6 into 4 minus 19 joules. In joules, it is minus only 13.6 into, if you convert, if you want to convert electron volts into joules, that becomes 1.6 in, multiply with 1.6 into 4 minus 19 joules. Now let us see the different series of spectral lines now.